Breaking news tonight. Springdale Police Department is responding to a three-vehicle accident on 48th Street, where a hit-and-run driver fled on foot, only to be struck by a vehicle on I-49. Due to the severity, Arkansas State Police are arriving on the scene. The man, identified as 45-year-old Robert Meek, is currently hospitalized. Meek faces DWI, careless driving, leaving the scene of an accident, and numerous other charges. Stay tuned for more details. Now, shedding light on the COVID-19 crisis. Since it began, Arkansas witnessed over a prolific 122,000 cases, resulting in over 99,000 inspiring recoveries and 23 tragic deaths. Within Arkansas, hotspots consisting of Pulaski, Washington, Independence, Sebastian, and Benton, cases continue to soar. Currently, Arkansas withstands 12,488 active COVID cases, while 786 hospitalized Arkansans fight a battle of life and death. During his COVID-19 update, Governor Asa Hutchinson provided all Arkansans with an inspiring call to action. We have a responsibility to our friends, family, and neighbors to do our part as we fight this virus. Quote Governor Hutchinson. Up next, are sidewalk pedestrians now in danger? Due to detrimental COVID-19 quarantine, many depressed Arkansans long for the freedom of the outside world. Fayetteville's trails have gained a 55% increase of overall traffic, leaving citizens to choose between quarantine insanity or a potentially lethal roadway getaway. In an attempt to find a free solution, the nonprofit Bike NWA and the city of Fayetteville are collaborating to construct the Slow Streets program. The Slow Streets program is designed to refurbish the now deadly roadways into sanctions for socially distanced outside family fun. Be heard and get involved by completing the Speak Up Fayetteville survey. Together, we can create safe roads and worry-free outdoor activity during this agonizing pandemic. Come visit the Don Tyson School of Innovation's ribbon-cutting ceremony this Monday at 2 o'clock p.m. DTSIO is welcoming you to celebrate the grand opening of his astonishing new facility, which provides over 75 new trade programs, including construction, welding, and robotics. Lieutenant Governor Tim Griffin, along with multiple partnered companies, are expected to make an appearance. There will also be a Be Pro, Be Proud truck containing information on career plans for students in the morning and afternoon. If you plan to attend the event, you may enter the Don Tyson School's East Entrance, as COVID regulations are going to be followed. After you receive your screening, you will be directed to the gym. Can't wait to see you there. This next story has a nice ring to it. An amazing discovery at the crater of Diamond State Park has gifted the self-proclaimed newbie, Steve McCool, with a 4.49-carat diamond. Father of two has decided to name Bam Bam the third largest diamond of the year after his children using their initials. What's more precious than a precious gem? My children, McCool proudly states. Anyone else looking to embark on a hunt for treasure can head to the Crater of Diamonds State Park, the only diamond mine in America completely open to the public. I'm Lexie Caplener signing off. Thank you for watching, and be sure to tune in next week for a new segment of JHS The Warning.